After a day of exploring Roebuck Bay's mangroves, Lisa joins us now from Broome, traditional lands of the Yaru people. Lisa, oh my God, that looks like heaven over there. What have you gotten up to today?
I actually am in heaven, Waleed. Over to my left, I'm watching a guy doing some pretty amazing paragliding. Behind me, you can see my brand new friends. They're just some of the camels that make that 2 kilometre trek up and down Cable Beach for all of the local tourists at sunset. It's such a must-do in this neck of the woods. And right in front of me is the iconic sunset bar at the Cable Beach Club, where 365 days a year, locals and tourists alike gather to do the only thing you should be doing in this place at sunset, and that is pulling up a bar stool, grabbing a cold one, and watching this magnificent orb sun disappear beneath the waves of the Indian Ocean.
Oh, there's nothing better than a sunset over the ocean in WA, Lisa. What else is on the cards today?
Well, I don't know if you guys know, but Broome is actually the pearling capital of Australia. And I must say, I showed enormous restraint today by not buying any, but I did go and try a hell of a lot on at Willy Creek Pearls. And no, I didn't make that name up, but I should have, because today I learned about the fascinating sex life of oysters who turn out these beautiful pearls. I don't know if you guys know, but oysters are actually hermaphrodites, and they make those beautiful creations, those pearls, in their gonads. So who knew such an ugly thing could create something so incredibly beautiful?
That's a shot of Pete.
Because you got Pete's attention.
I think it's in the eye of the beholder.
Yeah.
Lise, we believe you had a guide, Bart, but he wasn't the only one there, I believe.
That's right. I went out with local Yaru man Bart Pigram out onto the mudflats, which at the time I thought, I don't know if that's going to be so great. It was incredible. We set out really early and tried all the bush tucker on the mudflats. It's a freaking supermarket out there, Pete. And we waded through the most beautiful secluded pool. I heard stories of the Yaru Dreamtime. It was absolutely beautiful. And those mudflats are really crucial if you want to do another one of the must-dos here in Broome, and that is to witness something called the Stairway to the Moon, or Staircase to the Moon. It happens over 4 days. It's a natural phenomenon between March and October. And as you look over the mudflats, as the moon rises up out of the water, it actually looks like there's a staircase all the way to the moon, which was just incredible. But also, his beautiful kids, Agnes, Marley, and little Leo came along, and they were teaching me all sorts of things, like how to hold some really dangerous-looking crabs the right way. They showed me spitting octopi, which was amazing. Wow. And they also introduced me to a family of starfish. Have a look.
That's the mum, that's the sister, that's the baby.
Oh, kitties.
That is fantastic, Lisa.
So
you've got a beautiful sunset to watch
Chelsea,
there.
Chelsea, Lucy and Lindsay.
Beautiful, beautiful. And, Lise, I think you're there by yourself. You might want to go grab a margarita while you're there.
Yeah, I will. I definitely will. There's a lone bar still in the corner for all the lonely women who eat and drink all by themselves. So it's got my name written all over it, Pete.
Cheers, Lise. Cheers
well
from
up,
all
Lise.
Of us.